Hello and welcome to the PolyKit channel. Today's video is a bit different. I'm looking into fixing an old Italian synthesizer drum module. It is called Elka OMB 3. I read somewhere OMB stands for One Man Band. I don't know if that's true. I think it's from 1988 and in a pretty good shape, at least on the outside. The module has two instruments and a bass section, which can be controlled by MIDI. There are several different instruments that can be selected. Instruments can be controlled on separate MIDI channels or on a split keyboard. It also has predefined rhythms and arrangements which accompany the player. The rhythms got additional intro, ending and fill-in patterns. Volumes of every section can be adjusted separately. As far as I know, the module is not even powering on. So first we take a look on the inside and see what is going on. Okay, let's open it up. There were no real obvious problems on a first look. I checked the fuses and measured voltages on the power supply board. All seems fine. One of the voltage regulators obviously has been replaced, so I looked it up in the datasheet. The datasheet states a 5V regulator, but it has been replaced by a 6V regulator. Hard to tell why someone did this. Maybe there was no correct regulator at hand. So I'm going to revert this. I'm also going to replace all the electrolytic capacitors. They're over 30 years old, and this is something that is going to fail eventually. In the service manual, there is a notice that it is advised to replace two resistors on the output stage to increase the output level. This hasn't been done, so I replaced both resistors as well. It should triple the output volume. On the CPU board, I replaced the empty memory battery, so it should be possible to store settings again. I also replaced all capacitors here. After this, I dared to connect it to mains power, but still nothing on the front panel. While measuring voltages on the regulator, I noticed that it dropped to 1 volt. This means that there is a short circuit somewhere on the front panel board, because beforehand I only measured without it being connected to the CPU board. And indeed, while measuring between plus 5 volts and ground on the front panel, it confirmed that there is a short circuit on the board. So I took everything apart and also replaced the capacitors on this board. It came out that one of the capacitors had a resistance of 0 ohms and caused the short circuit. After giving everything a good clean and putting it back together, I tested it again, and voila, the module is powering on. So I hooked it up to a MIDI keyboard. Let's give it a try. Okay, pretty cheesy, but I guess this counts as a one-man band. The repair was a great success. Now the instrument is in a pretty good condition. Also, if you're interested in content like this, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. This helps a lot to keep me motivated and doing videos like this. Alright, that's all for today. Thanks for watching and bye for now.